Hey guys, welcome to this video. In this video, we're going to see that how you can use Bhim app for going cashless right now in this world of demonetization. As of now, today it is 11th of February 2017 and last night Bhim app was launched for iOS platform as well. So it has been launched for Android platform a couple of months back, probably one and a half or two months mostly, but it was not available for iOS app and now it is available for iOS platform as well. So I'm going to demonstrate how you use Bhim app, and that is for the first ever time. I probably am also using it for the first ever time because I also had an iPhone. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go into my app store, and there you go. I have recently installed this Bhim app. Now what you have to simply do is I'll click on search and I simply search for Bhim app over here. When I search for Bhim app, there are a couple of apps which we don't have to use. All right. These are useless apps. These are apps which people have just created for guides and all those things. The actual app is right over here. Let me just scroll down. It is from Indian government. So that app is this one, Bhim, where it says Bharat Interface for Money, and it says National Payments Corporation of for Money. If I click over here, let's read the entire description for that one. So it's not showing it over here actually, but if we go down over here, yeah, supported banks, coming soon banks, then Bharat Interface for Money, that is the full form of Bhim over here, is an initiative to enable fast, secure, blah 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 blah. So this is the actual app. So once you install, just open up the app and it will ask you to set your passcode. Now I have just set my passcode. All right, I have just set my passcode, and at that point in time I realized that let me just record and document how to set up the Bhim app for the first ever time. All right, so I haven't done anything, but I've just set my passcode. So I set my passcode, I'll just enter my passcode. And after you do that, straight away, let me just go to home. Actually, the first ever time when you do, it will ask you to select your bank. So let me just try to go back if I can. Bank. Change account. So for the first ever time, when you set your passcode, this is the option which you will be able to see. You'll be able to see all banks over here. All right, you'll be able to see all your banks over here. As of now, whatever has been updated, you will be able to see. If you're by chance, if unfortunately your bank is not available over here, you can just click on "Is your bank not available?" Just simply click on it, and you can report and you can mention your bank. Probably they'll keep it in the next update of this platform or this application. All right, so as of now, I have this bank which I want to demonstrate with. I have a couple of banks, but I'll just demonstrate it with Dena Bank over here. So I've selected Dena, and there you go, on the right hand side of Dena Bank, there is a green color tick mark. I'll click on next now. Once I click on next, it will directly link my bank account number and my IFSC code over here. All right, I don't have to enter my bank account number. My bank account number would be directly over here. The last four digits would be mentioned. Rest, it won't be visible due to security reasons, and the IFSC code would be mentioned over here, and the type of account, which is savings account. All right. Now you might be wondering, how does this happen? This happens because of the mobile number. All right. When you are setting up the passcode, before that, you will be asked for verifying your mobile number. Now, if your mobile is registered with your bank account, then only it will fetch all the details. So make sure you have your mobile number registered with your bank, which you want to link with your Bhim app, and you want to go cashless. So right now my mobile number is already registered, and that is the detail which I'm having. So I'll show you another bank as well. Let's say I have an ICICI account as well, where my mobile number is already linked. So I click on ICICI, and if I click on next, it will fetch all my details over here with the IFSC code and my bank account number and the type of account as well. But for the demonstration purpose, I want to use Dena Bank over here. I'll click on next, and now I'll click on the bank account detail. So tap once on the details, and on the next screen, you will be asked to set your UPI pin. All right, UPI pin. Now this is the four-digit UPI pin which is required, which you need to set up over here. You can set it up later as well by clicking on not now, but I would recommend that you set your UPI pin right now by clicking on this blue color button which says set UPI pin. So I'm going to click on that. Once I click on that, it will ask me the last six digits of debit card number which I have for this particular bank account. So now another mandatory thing over here is you need to have a debit card for this bank account which you want to use and link inside your Bhim app. All right, so you'll have to use the last 6 digits of debit card of the bank account which you're linking and the expiry date or the valid up to or the valid through date over here. So I'm going to enter those details over here. And now once I have entered all my details, I'll click on submit, which is right at the bottom, bottom right corner. Enter OTP. And there you go. I have the OTP, which is 9713. let me just enter 9713. And it's asking me to enter the new UPI pin. So let me just set my new UPI pin. And once you enter and set your new UPI pin, which you wish to have, click on submit once again, which is there at the bottom right corner. And it will ask you to confirm your new UPI pin. Once you enter it again, click on submit. Or has been successfully transferred on the next page. So let me just click on a couple of options over here. Let me just click on transactions. And it says you have not done any transactions so far. All right, so there won't be anything in pending. Let's go back. Let's click on profile. And it has generated one by default UPI with my number. All right, so there is my mobile number, @ UPI on the top below my barcode, which I can share with somebody so that they can pay me. So if you have been using Paytm to send and receive money, this is the same way you can use this barcode, which is linked with your Bhim app now. All right. And you can download this probably over here. And let's click on download. If I click on download, all right, so it's asking me to download and it has already downloaded the barcode over here. I can always share this. Let's click on share. And it is asking me to share so I can save this image, I can mail it or whatever you wish to have and you can receive your money. Let's go back. Let's click on bank accounts over here. And once I click on bank account, it is asking me to reset UPI pin, change UPI pin, 4-digit UPI pin already exists, request balance. So let me just click on request balance for this one. So when I requested the balance, it is asking me enter UPI pin. Once you enter your UPI pin, click on submit. All right, bingo. So it is actually showing you the balance over here, which is there inside your bank account. All right, obviously I would be blurring this and you won't be able to see this because of security reasons. But as of updated, I just checked in my mobile as well on my application that it is correct. It is the exact detail over here. All right, it is the exact detail over here. And if you don't see the exact detail, you can always click on the sync, which is there right at the bottom. Probably it will help you to update all the things. All right, so I'll click on back now. And now let's try to send some money. All right, let me try to send money to my other account and let's see if it works or not. So for that, I'll click on send, which is on the top out of those three options, which say send, second is request, third is scan and pay. So I'm going to click on send right now. And it's asking me mobile or payment address. Please enter mobile number or payment address above. So let's just click on these three dots on the top right corner, which is there. And let's see what happens over there. All right, bingo. So what you have is, if you don't have mobile payment address, you can always enter your account number and IFSC code for the person whom you want to send some money. Or you can have the aadhar pay. All right, aadhar pay. Now for aadhar pay, I read somewhere, I'm not sure, so please do your own research because it is a recent app, so I cannot guarantee anything. But to my knowledge, whatever I have read online, if I click on aadhar pay, then what will happen is the person whom you are sending money, you will require their aadhar number. Now the interesting thing over here, or the first question which might have been in your mind right now, would be if that person is, or if that person has already linked their Aadhaar number to two or more accounts, all right? That is two or three accounts they have linked their Aadhaar number, which account would be linked when you enter your Aadhaar number? The answer to that is whatever I read online, but whatever I know, I'm telling you from my experience. So when you enter the Aadhaar number and you want to send money to them, the bank account in which the money would be transferred would be the bank account which they have linked their Aadhaar card the last. So let's suppose I have Dena Bank and ICICI Bank right now, which I showed you. And if I have only two accounts with me right now, then let's assume Dena Bank I opened up first. All right. And then I link my Aadhaar card. Now, after 3 months, I have opened up my ICICI account and I have linked my Aadhaar number with ICICI bank account as well. So the last bank account which was linked with your Aadhaar number would be the bank account in which the money would be transferred. All right. So that is an issue over here. So probably you will have to verify with the person whom you are transferring the money. You'll have to first double check with them that which is the last account which they have linked with your Aadhaar number. If that is the account in which they want to get transferred the money, then you can go ahead with Aadhaar Pay, or else you can always go ahead. All right. So it was a timeout probably. So I'll once again enter my passcode and I'll click on this. So you can now click on account plus IFSA and let's try to do by that one. So account and blah, blah, blah. Or what I'll do is I know my bank account in which I have linked my Aadhaar card. And let's try by that. So I'll click on Aadhaar Pay. And I will enter my Aadhaar number over here. And let's see if I get my money into my bank account. I'll try to transfer my money from one account to another. And probably in my last account, which is my ICICI account, which I opened up, my Aadhaar number is linked over there. So I'll try to enter my Aadhaar number over here and let's see what happens next. All right. So I have entered my Aadhaar number over here and let me just try to click verify. And it's saying something like this, and this about details is irrespective of us. That is by default the NPCI who is doing. And let's say I'll try to transfer a small amount of, let's say, 100 rupees and save it for future. All right. So I'll save it for future as well. And let's click on send. It's asking me to enter my UPI pin. So let me just enter my UPI pin. Let's click on submit. All right. So it says could not send money. An unknown error occurred. Go to home. So let's just click on go to home. So probably that Aadhaar Pay method is not working right now. And maybe there is some bug, or maybe that is not properly linked with my ICICI bank account. So let's once again click on send. Let's try all the methods and let's click on these three dots and let's say account plus IFSC. And I'm going to now enter my details over here. All right. So I have all my details over here filled in and now I'm going to click on send and let's try to enter the amount. Let's say I'll go by 100 once again, future. And let's see if it happens over here or not. And bingo, it says money sent. You have successfully sent 100 rupees to the bank account and it's already been there over here on the top. Dear customer, account so-and-so is credited with 100 rupees. So it is actually working over here. So I'll click on go to home, ask me later. And let's go into the transactions and let's see if it is happening or not. Yes, indeed. There you go. The first one, which is shown in the red, the orange color, which is in pending, is the one which we tried with Aadhaar Pay, which is not working right now, probably due to some error from my bank account error or maybe some bug fixes. And I've got the message of debited account from Dena Bank. So I transferred 100 rupees from my Dena Bank account to my ICICI account using this Bhim App, and it is successfully working, guys. It is successfully working. So this is the transaction which is being done. Let's try to click on that. And yes, indeed, it is working. There is a payment ID, there is a date, there is a time, remarks is test, and you can call the bank by clicking below. All right. So sending the money using Bhim App on iOS App Store on 11th of February 2017 was successful. All right, was successful. And let's see if we want to request money, how we can do that. Let's click on request. And for requesting the money, you can either enter the mobile or the payment address, or you can click on the barcode, which is there in the top right corner. So if I click on barcode and I can just enter the amount. So let's say I want to request 100 rupees and I'm not going to enter anything on remarks, and I can click on generate specific QR code for 100 rupees. All right. This is the 100 rupees for this one. All right. And now I can simply have this particular thing shared with some other people. And then you can actually scan and pay, which you might be using with Paytm. So I can click on scan and pay. And if you are into a shop and if you have a barcode, then you can just simply scan that barcode. Obviously, I have a book below this. So if I do this, I can actually show you all these things. All right. I'm recording this on my MacBook. So that is what is scanning. So once you scan the barcode of the respective shop, then you can straight away pay money. So that is how this is. This is the home page, guys. Let's click on the bell button, which is there on the top. And it is just simply for notifications. And the three dots, let's click on that. So it's all about this app, all right? You can log out, you can cancel and blah, blah, blah. So I have successfully done the transaction of money from Bhim app, and hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, do subscribe to my channel, do like and do give me a thumbs up, share it with your friends who needs to go cashless in this demonetization world, and let me know what you think in the comments below. I'll see you in some another video. Till then, take care, bye-bye, and as always, guys, stay awesome.